Humans have been perfecting their sensory abilities for millions of years. Eyesight, combined with brain power, allows people to identify faces, recognize objects, perceive their environment, and then take action based on those observations. In the Center for Automation Research, known as CIFAR, Maryland researchers are committed to bringing these same sensory skills to modern computing platforms.
We've been working on the problem of computer vision for over 50 years, trying to give computers the ability to see with the same type of accuracy that people do, to be able to recognize everyday objects, everyday actions of people, and the context in which they're being done.
While CIFAR has almost 24 faculty and research scientists in its 4 unique labs, it can trace its roots back to the dedicated efforts of one man.
The center was established by Azriel Rosenfeld, who was a research professor here in College Park. And Azriel really was the founder of the whole field of computer vision. He wrote the first textbook, and he started the first journal, and he started the first conference, and he probably wrote most of the first few hundred papers.
Research in CIFAR today includes new visualization tools that are used in healthcare. These groundbreaking applications can help medical professionals gain new insight into serious conditions like traumatic brain injury or Parkinson's disease. Projects in virtual and augmented reality are also underway, creating immersive, interactive platforms that let people see and use information that matters most to them. CIFAR has also developed technology that allows people to access more than 10,000 news feeds from around the world simply by clicking on a map location. And if you want to know what songbird is chirping outside of your window, check out BirdSnap, an electronic field guide that can identify thousands of species of birds in the wild. For public safety, CIFAR is building facial recognition software that can identify people in less than perfect environments, even if they're slightly out of focus or moving away from a surveillance camera.
The holy grail here is to understand what's in an image, what's in a video, who is in it, what they're doing, when the image was taken, where the image was taken. So we consider all of this as inference problem. Given a single image or a video sequence, how much information can you gather from there?
Recent work in CIFAR involves autonomous robotic systems, designing robots that will soon be able to think and act on their own. This means that humanoid robots, using skills obtained from artificial intelligence, computer vision, and language processing software, could soon be helping out around your house or apartment.
In our project with robots, we are trying to create a technology so that robots eventually can interact with humans. So one thing is they need to understand what humans are doing, what their actions are. And for that, we need tools so they can pick up their action, track them, and all that in real time.
One project has robots watching YouTube cooking videos.
Hi, I am Julia, your personal chef.
And then using their own knowledge system to figure out the best way to make a salad.
I am looking for the dressing.
When these cognitive robots that see and reason and act in the world appropriately, it will change fundamentally our societies.
What else can I do for you today?